Welcome to Marvel TLDR, presented by Noah Sterling. This is the series where we break down Marvel's greatest stories so you can jump right in and read the original adventures. Today's story is Spider-Gwen. Alright, so for this story, we are in alternate universe mode. That means the Marvel universe as you know it is totally different. Gwen Stacy is alive, Daredevil is evil, and the Punisher works for the police. But J. Jonah Jameson is the same fear-mongering blowhard he's always been, because apparently that's a multiversal constant.
Spider-Woman? How can we expect a woman to handle all the powers and abilities of a spider? Why, if she were Spider-Man, I wouldn't be complaining. No, sir.
Spider-Woman is Gwen Stacy, an average teenager who is bitten by the radioactive spider instead of Peter Parker. Now she's the one who uses amazing spider powers to fight crime. Gwen also just has the coolest costume, with a physics-defying hood that miraculously always stays on her head when she's swinging around. Gwen's nerdy boyfriend, Peter Parker, got tired of being bullied and turned himself into the Lizard, resulting in his death. Because of a misunderstanding, everyone thinks Spider-Woman killed him, and now the police are after her, including her own dad, Captain Stacy. But on one fateful day, Gwen saves her dad's life from one of the Kingpin's super-powered henchmen. She reveals her secret identity to her dad, at which point he decides to lay off her a bit.
Hey, Foggy, so I was thinking, Spider-Woman, maybe not a menace that needs to be captured?
Oh, don't worry, George. The mayor won't ask you to catch her anymore.
Oh, that's great, Foggy. Tell him I appreciate it. I really do.
He's asking the Punisher to go after her instead.
Well, that's just fine and dandy. Wait, what?!
Later, the Vulture flies around, wreaking havoc across the city. Gwen calls out the Vulture with some rather impolite graffiti. The Vulture tosses Gwen out of the sky, but she survives by falling into a garbage barge. The Vulture is working for Matt Murdock, who is the Kingpin's lawyer and right-hand man. Under Matt's orders, the Vulture attacks Captain Stacy in his own home, but the Captain shoots the Vulture and he flees. Gwen chases the Vulture and captures him.
Yes! I win! Take that, you old man with the bullet wound! Oh, wow. I do not feel good about this.
Punisher time! Yes, I did it! I finally captured a teenage girl who was half my size. Wow, I do not feel good about this.
Yoink!
And this is only the beginning of Gwen's troubles. Soon enough, she'll have to deal with the Kingpin, the Lizard's return, S.H.I.E.L.D. adding her to their wanted list, and worst of all, teen drama with her band. TLDR, if you're the only superhero in an alternate universe who has their own comic book, every problem is your problem. Thanks for watching this video. Read the original Spider-Gwen comics on Marvel Unlimited, on the Marvel Comics app, or in graphic novel edition wherever comics are sold.